Hey, what's up, YouTube? This is James from Big Sky Reptiles. So I have got a really cool lizard. I wanted to show you guys the unboxing of it. I haven't even seen it yet. This is a Caiman lizard. It has pretty much been the lizard that I've wanted more than anything for probably the last couple of years. Ever since I first saw him. I am new to Caiman lizards. I've got tegus, I've got other kinds of animals, I've got monitors. This is gonna be something new for me. It's added to the collection. We're really super excited about it. It's not a breeding project of any kind. We're probably gonna use them for kiddos shows because we do James the Jungle as well. And but anyway, let's get to it. I'm just gonna show you this, this guy. After a brief outtake. Oh yes, I know. You're very angry. It's okay, you're okay. Right. Okay. All right, now he's calmed down a little bit. Check this guy out. He's got some fantastic color. So body, it really does have the body of a crocodile, the tail of a crocodile. Like, you really do look just like a croc or a caiman. But then they have that head that looks just like, very, very similar to a tegu. Yeah, he's very healthy too. You can tell he's definitely been eating well. And he does look like either he's got a chunk taken out of him at one point on his back leg, or maybe a burn or something like that. I don't know. We'll see how he heals up, because it definitely looks like it still needs to heal some, whatever it is. I was told this was a male. I really don't know. And someday when this guy's a lot more calmer, ready to just chill, then we're gonna work with him. We're gonna have to work with this guy some. But caimans can be a little bit crazy, and when it comes to, they can be a little bit defensive when they're in their closure, especially when it comes time to eat. They can be very, very enclosure defensive, but they don't drop their tail. These guys don't, which is a huge bonus. I've never heard of them dropping their tail, and all the research I've done on them says that they don't drop their tail. Man, this guy's cool. My dream animal, guys. My dream animal. Look at that. Look at the colors. I wish you guys. I don't know if you guys can really see the colors of this guy, but it is super, super cool. Check out this tail. Yeah, now that he's in the hand, man, he just is chill, relaxed, doesn't want to bite me all of a sudden now. And that's what I heard about him. I hear that, you know, sometimes it can be a little rough getting him picked up. But once they're in the hand, they just chill out. Look at this guy. He's just hanging out now. He doesn't even care. Not a care in the world. Now I will say he's probably nervous about his new smells, the new enclosure that's right in front of him. And, you know, he doesn't know me from anything. And so he's probably... freezing up a little bit because of that, because he's just not sure of the of what's going on, which is very typical of lizards. They'll, you know, a lot of people will be like, oh, I got this tegu, and when I pulled him out of the bag, he was super chill, he's such a great animal, and then a week later, he was the meanest thing I've ever seen, and that happens. That happens more often than not with animals, because when they first get out, their defensive mode is to freeze, and they either run or they freeze, and he's probably in that freeze mode now because he ran at first there. I don't know if you guys saw. We'll maybe do some outtakes or something like that. But it took a little bit to calm him down, to get him up into my hand without getting bit. But even if this guy bit me, you know, they don't have those massive teeth. They have molars. They're just round molars. They're really, really cool. And they're made for crushing snail shells. And they crush them. And then they will take that meat out with their, they'll just keep crushing and crushing and moving that meat around until it actually comes out. And then they will, after it's out, they spit that, they spit the shell out for the most part. They might get some of it eaten, but they'll spit that shell out and they'll eat the meat. And I've seen some pictures with, or some videos and whatnot of enclosures that are used for caimans, I mean for the caiman lizard, that also have like cichlids in them. Like convict cichlids are like, you can't kill a convict. They're just super, super hardy animals. So, sorry, about running out of battery here. Anyway, stay tuned, guys. So I'm gonna keep uploading videos. This is my first video I've done. I'm gonna continue to work on this guy's enclosure over the next week or so here, and I'm gonna take some video footage of actually working on it and getting it put together. But it's massive. It's gonna be huge. It'll be the only enclosure he ever needs. It's a 6 foot. 6 foot by 24 by 18. 134 gallon tank, and it's also gonna have an actual enclosure up on top, made out of PVC and like sheets of PVC, and it's gonna be legit. It's gonna be a really, really nice enclosure for this guy. He'll never have to have another one. It'll be big enough for him as an adult. So, and it's gonna be a display animal for sure. Yeah. Absolutely love this guy. So cool. So incredibly cool. All right. Thanks for watching, guys. Hey, hit that subscribe button and give me a like if you enjoyed the video. If you learned a little bit, it helps me out growing my channel and lets me go ahead and comment below what you thought about the video and what I can work on. I'm new to this gig, so yeah. Anyway. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a great day.